which is rate of reinforcement. So that's what you're talking about when you're talking about time. How many rewards does a dog get in a period of time, and how frequent are those rewards? So separate from the behavior the dog's doing, but the rate of reinforcement. And so we manipulate that in our teaching process. So generally speaking, and again, these are gonna be different depending on what you're working on, what kind of arousal levels you're trying to create, where you are in the training process, et cetera. But in the general idea behind it is, early in your training sessions, when you're first training with a dog, you may have seen me right before class in with my puppy, the rate of reinforcement is incredibly high, meaning there's very little time between rewards. It's like, bang, 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 do this, bang, 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 do this, bang, 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 do this, bang, 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 bang. And he's getting rewarded through that whole thing, like every couple of seconds, and sometimes more, like it's a wham, wham. So basically what we're doing is, one, the dog is inherently successful. I just don't give them a chance to do anything else, and they get a whole bunch of rewards, and I don't give them a chance to pay attention to other things. Of course, you don't want to keep doing that. You can't maintain that. That's at the early stages. As I recognize that the dog is working better and starting to understand, I reduce the rate of reinforcement. I extend the amount of time in between rewards on purpose. Because if you don't, and if I'm very predictable and my dog gets a reward every 10 seconds and then they don't get a reward, they start to say, oh, and they check out on you, right? So I'm going to have to mess with that reinforcement rate of reinforcement as well. So I start to go longer between rewards, and then I come back and give a bunch in a row, and then I start to go longer still, and then I come back and give, and I go longer still, and we keep pushing for the dog's ability to continue to work for longer periods of time in between rewards. I think that for many behaviors, dogs are not aware. There are certain aspects of a behavior that a dog can be aware of, and for certain types of behaviors, and many of the obedience behaviors, the dogs are not aware of the quality of the behavior. Meaning your dog sits, but they don't know how fast they sat. And they're not like, wham, yeah, that was a super one. I expect big payday, right? How well they do a behavior is usually a function of their motivational state and understanding at the time you ask them to do it. And so if a dog does something slowly but correctly, you should reward the crud out of that, because the dog did it, but they're not anticipating good rewards. They're in a bad state of mind motivationally, right? So the reason they did it slowly is because they weren't expecting much on their end from you. And if you don't reward that because it's slow, you confirm their suspicions, more or less, right? Whether they're consciously thinking this, but the idea is they're in a low state of motivation because they're not expecting a good reward. They go slowly and you say, that wasn't good enough, and you give them, don't give them a reward. It makes it worse, not better, right? They are aware that they actually executed the behavior you asked them to do correctly. And so the quality of that behavior itself is difficult. Now, if my dog does a behavior incorrectly, sits and flops over, then I'm not going to reward that one. When the dog sits properly, I'll reward that one, right? So there are elements of a behavior that a dog could potentially be aware of that could be defined as quality. But usually when we're talking about quality is the intensity, the energy, the speed, the precision of those things. And in those cases, I don't think the dog is consciously aware of those things. Like, I'm going to sit slow. I know he wants me to sit fast, but to hell with it, I'm sitting slow, right, kind of thing. And so I think they don't recognize those things. And periodically giving the dog very good rewards will make the responses that follow it better, right? So if my dog's last five rewards were his favorite thing in the world, in all likelihood, the next time you prompt him to do that behavior, it's gonna be good. Because he's like, yeah, I know what I'm getting. I'm getting filet mignon this time, I know it, right? And so he sits like, wham! And sure enough, yes! Right? And you're off to the races. But I think that that's a difficult notion for dogs, the idea that they're aware of the quality of their responses. They're just usually aware of whether or not they're doing what they're trained to do or not. And the quality is driven by their state of motivation at the time you ask them to do it.